for evaluation of intellectual capital. This is the first case study, and this is published as a research article. Second case study, this is also published as a research paper. This is the earthquake prediction system. And there are third case study. This is this case study. It is related to washing machine. Okay, so the same washing machine that you have studied in the lab, the fuzzy logic control application design and simulation for washing machine. So these case studies are published in the form of paper. So see, this paper was published in the journal. So these are the open access journals. Name of the journal is here. So IOP Publishing, and it's published in 2019, and it is a conference series. So these paper are published in INCI test conference. Okay, so you may publish such a paper on taking some case studies, a newer case study of your interest, like I am exploring like this washing machine case study of fuzzy logic. So just you see how this case studies are written. So like adjusting the font size, I think. So the name of this paper is Fuzzy Logic Control Application Design and Simulation for Washing Machine. So this was published in 2019. This is a recent paper. 2019 is not very old. This is a recent research paper. And what it's saying is the abstract. Abstract is very important. That is the core of any research paper. So you have to publish paper like this in your M.Tech thesis. Okay, not now, but in your M.Tech thesis you have to publish like this paper. You may start publishing your paper like this. So taking some abstract. Abstract is the conclusion of this paper. What is saying? This paper aims to model and simulate based on user expert knowledge using fuzzy logic. Fuzzy logic inference process to control washing machine. In this study, use Mamdani method. The method is Mamdani method that I shown you earlier. This method is used, Mamdani method. The method has four steps. Fuzzification of the linguistic variable, first. Second, rule evaluation. Based on expert experience, rule evaluation, many rules, rule-based expert system. Third, aggregation of the rules at output. And final, defuzzification. So here are, so fuzzification, here are defuzzification. And rest are aggregation and rule-based. So these are the four basic steps. So if you read this paper, you will find the actual working that is going on this area, and you will find the more clear concepts on this domain. So because this is very important part. So input linguistic variable are used for dirtiness of the clothes. Dirtiness means, so level of the dirtiness like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is for linguistic variable. Type of fabric, that is another variable, means which type, cotton, silk, etc. Type of dirt is another variable. And amount of the clothes, so how much, 1 kilo, 2 kilo, 3 kilo, that is another variable. And the output variable is the washing time. So the same thing we did in the laboratory, lab 1, experiment 1. So the washing speed, the water intake, and water temperature are the variable. So if this depends upon the output variable washing time, how much time it will take, how much the washing speed it requires, how much water intake, how frequent water intake it will take, and what will be appropriate washing temperature. So if it is a woolen cloth, the temperature should not be high. Okay. So can you please share it? Okay. So are you able to view my screen now? Yes, Binay. Binay, I can see the message. Yes, Binay, are you able to see my this paper? This paper sharing a washing machine case study. Yes, Priyanka and Vina. Yes, yes, visible. So okay. Yes, yes, yes. And it is the Priyanka. So this is is very important session, because in this session you will learn how to write a case study. So later on I will share this paper in your group, or you can directly find this paper on Google. Just Google it and download it. Okay. I am sending the name. So sending of the name, you can directly go and download this paper. I directly download it. It is available. So how can you download this paper? Just go here. I downloaded here. So just it is directly available. Fuzzy logic control application. Just write on the Google, you will find. Fuzzy logic control application, design and simulation of the washing machine. So this is directly available. You just go and put this keyword on Google. This paper is available on ResearchGate, the first link. And in the first link, you just go here, article PDF. This is downloadable. This did not require your membership. It's downloaded now. Go here and download here. So and save here. So now it's downloaded. So your case study can be written in this way. These are the, and can you publish? You may publish your paper like this way. This is a short paper. So I'm scrolling this paper. So this paper, it is just a sample. You can choose any other domain. So I am just reading few lines of this paper. So these are the rules, fabric types, and etc. Washing speed, washing temperature. The system is designed, designed and simulated using Fuzzy Logic Toolbox on MATLAB. So it is used at my MATLAB platform to implement and simulate. It is also shown that the washing machine inference relate to user expert perceptions. The main advantage of using this fuzzy logic in washing machine is that it reduces the water. What is the advantage? Reducing the water and electricity consumption, and also good time management. So ultimately, the result is, and in the shape of water, reduction of the electricity consumption and reduction of the time. So this is this steps. This optimize this washing machine. Okay. So and 4 or 5 page papers, you may, this is the introduction part, this is the introduction of the fuzzy logic and giving references. Here are the references, and thereafter the method, the same method you can write in the program number 1 of your lab experiment. This is the method. I am explaining this block diagram because it might help in your lab as well. So this is the block diagram. So these are the inputs, like input of the dirtness, input type of the dirt, means which type of dirt, whether it is a permanent type of dirt, temporary dirt, or this is an color type of dirt, and color dirt, etc. Volume of the clothes, 1 kilo, 2 kilo, 1/2 kilo, 5 kilo. So it is a, every washing machine has its capacity, 2 kg, 3 kg capacity, that is a volume, and type, woolen, silk, nylon. So because we set the temperature, okay, for woolen clothes we can't put high temperature, and for cotton we can set high temperature. So it reduces the time, temperature reduces the time, okay. So if we put low temperature, it increases the time. So here are the washing time, here are the washing speed, here are the washing temperature, here are the water intake. So washing speed can't be put high for delicate coarse clothes having a moderate speed. Wash time is higher for high type of dirt or permanent dirt. So temperature depends upon the season as well, because this is like winter season, we can put high temperature. In the summer season, we can run the machine without any heating, because the normal temperature of the water is on room temperature in summer. So it also indicates the water temperature, the environment variable. It can be sensed with some environmental variable. Here the water intake, how much water it will take. So all are, first is the fuzzification, inference engine is the decision making engine. Okay, this is the inference, this is decision making, and defuzzification for as the output. So defuzzification gives the output here, takes input here, and defuzzification gives the output. This is a block diagram. So the design of controller for washing machine. Okay, so this is the one example, and it was implemented in MATLAB. So it will be very useful. So I will try to demonstrate you some example later on in the lab session regarding this experiment. So in the second diagram, what is showing? So the simulated washing machine on MATLAB. So this is the what it simulated washing machine, and Mamdani algorithm is there. Mamdani method is applied. So all rules and regulations are collected here and giving the output in the terms of washing time and water temperature, etc. So these are the input signals, these are the output signals. So the simulated washing machine on MATLAB. These are the fuzzification process. I mean this table 1. So suppose, see this table. So the input variable and membership function. Here are the membership range, here are the membership value, here are the input value variable, like dirtness. It might be small, medium, large. So membership range is 0 to 100. 100 is the maximum, 0 is the minimum. So minimum dirtness to maximum dirtness, 0 to 100%. Type of the dirt, not greasy, greasy. So, and medium, not greasy, medium, and greasy. Three types of range, 0 to 100, 0% to 100%. Type of the fabric, silk, woolen, cotton, 0 to 100%. Volume of the clothes, small, medium, large. It is not given in kilo. Okay, so it is given small, medium, and large, because for a bigger washing machine, 1 kilo might be a small volume, but a smaller washing machine, 1 kilo might be a medium, or very small washing machine, 1 kilo may be a large volume. Okay, it's depending upon the size of that washing machine. suppose generally a washing machine can load 3 or 4 kilo. That is a medium range. But a big washing machine, so that can load 10 kg, 15 kg or laundry type professional washing machine, commercial washing machine. So even 5 kg is small. So they usually takes 10 kg, 12 kg load. So it is a relative term. So it is written small, medium and large, not in kilo. Okay. So that it can be implied in every size of machine, small to commercial type. So I am not going in detail in this paper. This is only a sample example. So you can write case studies like this and publish your paper. The defuzzification, these are the formula of defuzzification. So these are the integration. Mu is the mean, A and X. A is therefore any type of accumulator or any type of function that depends upon the A, or the aggregate function. That is a function of again X dx, and divided by again integration of, these are the mu for the mean of all X dx. So AX dx, AX dx, and here is A to B, here is again A to B. So these are the main defuzzification. So here the output variable. So output, like here you can see 0 to 100, here 0 to 1200, 0 to 100, 0 to 80. So these are for a particular type of setting. So temperature is 80 degree, and here are water intake, 100 means full water intake. Here is 1200 means washing speed is more. 100 is suppose the medium, and 1200 is 1200 RPM, and it is 0 to 100. So it can be 0, can be 100, depending upon the range, the result and discussion. Here are some graphical representation. So I can show you. So input 50 50 50 50, four variables: dirt, type of the dirt, temperature and time. So suppose 50 50 50 50 type of the clothes, suppose 50. Here the type of the dirt is 50. Suppose there is a value is 50. Type of the dirtness is 50. Type of the bottom of the clothes 50. Washing time is 46.7. So these are symbolically. So you can put this value here. This will show graphically. Here, left, right, down, up. So these are the graphical presentation. It is just some images showing the surface relationship between input variable, type of the dirt, and type of the clothes. So you can see the surface relationship. It is called. So here are 3D images. Washing time is here. Type of dirt is in this side, and type of the clothes is this side. So this is a 3D image. So again, 3D images and conclusion. So 1 minute, please. Okay. Hello. हाँ मैं थोड़ी क्लास ले रही, थोड़ी देर बाद बात कर सकता हूँ? After half an hour. So I am showing you the another case study. So these are the references you can put. There only were 11 references. That is the minimum references. You may put more references. So more the references, more the justifiable, and more less the plagiarism. Okay. So if you put less and less references, so chances of the plagiarism is higher, because So your content might be somewhere published, and that gives a plagiarism or similarity report. So if you give, suppose this content having some similarity report, so if you give the references, that will be excluded from plagiarism. Otherwise, it will treat it as copying content. So reduction of the plagiarism is giving more and more references. And otherwise, you have if you have original content, so keep you can put it without any references. So it's always helpful to give more and more references. Now there is second case study, that is here. So this is the earthquake prediction system. So recently you feel an earthquake in Punjab. So you can make such a system, such a fuzzy system, or any case study depending upon the fuzzy expert system. So this paper was published when 2017, January 2017, paper was published. So this is the year of the publication, and see the name of the journal. Name of the journal where is the journal I think journal or in the research gate it is a conference paper. It is a conference paper, and so all the content of this page was uploaded by the Mehdi Jere. So it's not showing clearly the name of the journal, but it is a conference paper. Might be it's published in some proceedings. Okay, so but ResearchGate give it its platform to publish it. So now see this research paper. The name of this fuzzy system is earthquake prediction system, and it is a case study. And this is the case study of the Gyros Range. This is the name of the place where this experiment was conducted. Because earthquake depending upon the area to area, land to land. Like in Japan, there is a most likely earthquake happening, but in India, some places are very safe. They are very less likely to earthquake. So this case study is happens or is studied in this Gyros Range. This Gyros Range is a place where some frequent earthquakes happens. So now, and it was funded by the National Center for the Earthquake Prediction, International Institute of the Earthquake Engineering and Seismology. So, and in this paper was published in Iran. This was funded Iran, Tehran. Okay, and Arsh Andalib and the Mehdi Jare and Fred Attree, the three authors were studying this. Now I am only reading this abstract. Rest will be briefly. I will demonstrate. So first, what is saying the abstract, and enlarging the fonts of abstract. A methodology for the development of a FES, fuzzy expert system, with application to earthquake prediction is presented. The idea is to be reproduce the performance of a human expert in earthquake prediction. What about the idea of developing this case study? So the human expert's performance to embed in some machine. So performance of human expert in earthquake prediction is to be implemented in this case study. To do this, the first step rules provided by the human expert. Those who were expert of earthquake, we just collected the rules and used to generate a fuzzy rule base. By these rules, we generate a fuzzy rule base. These rules are then fed into an inference engine, that is a decision engine, to produce a fuzzy inference system, FIS. So this is embedded in fuzzy inference system is decision making system, and to infer the results. In this paper, we have used an Sugeno type fuzzy inference system. Which type of fuzzy system? Sugeno type of fuzzy inference system to build the fuzzy expert system, FES. At the next step, the adaptive network based fuzzy inference system, ANFIS, adaptive network fuzzy inference system, is used to define this fuzzy expert system parameters and improve its performance. The proposed framework is then employed to attain the performance of a human expert used to predict earthquakes in a Georges area based on the idea of the coupled earthquake. Where is this area? You can Google it. Z-A-J-G-R-O-S. Just search on Google. I am finding on Google. Z-A-G-R-O-S. So just see, Georges is a mountain area. It is a mountain area. Earthquakes is very frequent here. See the mountain area. Okay. And it is a long mountain range in Iran, northern Iraq, and southern Turkey. So this is the mountain area of Zagros. It is pronounced Z-A-G or Zagros. Okay. Just see this Zagros mountain valley. So it is like Himalayan valley. Here earthquakes are very frequent. So because due to the pressure of the seismographic plates and okay, so this paper, I was just studying this paper. Yeah, Zagros area based on the idea of the coupled earthquake. Okay, so while the prediction results are promising in part of the testing sets, the general performance indicates that the prediction methodology based on the coupled earthquakes needs more investigation and more complicated reasoning procedure to yield satisfactory predictions. Coupled earthquakes are two earthquakes simultaneously. What are the coupled earthquakes? We can see the reference. What are coupled earthquake? So just clear the concepts of what are the coupled earthquake, coupling and uncoupling. So these are seismic coupling has been a qualitative measure of the interaction between two plates. Okay, two plates having the same time earthquake and the subduction of the zones. So the coupling earthquakes are, so there are earthquake between two plates. Okay, that is a coupled earthquake. So now I am going quickly to the paper because it is long. I think how many pages? So it's having 4 or 5 pages. So I'm going briefly. So how can you write your case study or your research paper? So this type of research paper, you can see there's some introduction and with references. So here a Zagros area belt, introduction of the Zagros area belt of the southwest of the Iran, and there are some history when the earthquake came and which magnitude it came, like magnitude more than 5 or equal to 5, So some data are there, some references are there. So you can put like this, the introduction part. Here are some, now this is important part. After introduction, it's giving some rule, rule one, rule two. So genotype Fuzzy inference system with two rules, rule one and rule two, and four membership functions. So here are some rule one and rule two, and here are the membership function. So in the rule one, L1, L2, and here is again two rules, L3, L4. So this graph comes as a, and it is and going flatter. It is going some flatter, thereby again going sharper. Then this graph, there is flatter graph, sharp graph, then flatter graph. So the methodology is here. Here are the block diagram of the same expert system, modification, crisp input. Input means in the form of 011, crisp modification. And these are fed back to rule based. This arrow, see this modification. This is directly fed back to rule based. It is a rule based. If then else, if then else. So genotype of the fuzzy inference system. So these are the rules. This input and crisp output. Meanwhile, the expert opinion are taken. Expert opinion are taken. It is given to rule based, and it is also connected to fuzzification. So here are the expert opinion. Here are the results. So the architecture of an expert based on the Sugeno type of the fuzzy inference system. Just see this graph. 1 minute, please. Okay. Now, these are the graph of a seismicity map of Georges or Jagras. So these are the graphs that is given, that is provided by the some geologist and the seismographic department of Iraq and Iran. Here the Iran and Iraq. Here are some active zones, and these are the some colors having 5 magnitude of having this color, green color, red magnitude having 5.3 color, and white for 5.6, and so on. So these are colorings, and these are the magnitudes of the earthquake. Maximum earthquake is 7.4. So 7.4 is the maximum earthquake. Here are the minimum. So minimum is the 5 and maximum is the 7.4, and 8 are the high impact earthquakes, and even 5 is a moderate type of the earthquake. So we studied here between 5 to 7.4. So and above 7.4, that is a very destructive earthquake. 8 magnitude, 8.5, 9, that is a very very high impact earthquakes. So these are the, on the basis of this graph, patterns were put, that is correlated with the years. In 1986 this impact earthquake came, this 1987 this earthquakes come in this area, in 88 these earthquakes came on this area, and 89. So this type of pattern we extracted the magnitude of the real quakes of the 6 months ahead prediction. Now, a star is for real, dot is for prediction. So these are the real earthquake came of lower magnitude. We predict for the higher magnitude, but the actual came of the lower magnitude. So actual and but earthquake came, yes came, but came of the lower magnitude. Here the magnitude, earthquake magnitude. Okay. So this fuzzy inference system, why successfully predicts the future earthquakes, but yes, there are differences in some magnitude only. Okay. So suppose the we predict of this 6.5 magnitude, but real earthquake came 6 magnitude. So there is very little difference, 6 magnitude, and we predicted 6.5, but earthquake came in the time. We predicted at this time slot, earthquake came little after that. Okay, so this is very successful for the prediction of the earthquake in any area. These are the acknowledgement and other things. So every paper you must give some acknowledgement, means thankful. So the author thanks. The author would like to thank, this is the supposed his guide or this the people in the department. And 6 references are there. So like this, likewise this, you may write your paper of research study and publish your paper. Okay. So now I can see one more. This is one more paper of case study. So this is a fuzzy rule based expert system for the evaluation of intellectual capital. What are intellectual capital? Like your patent, like your research paper, like your design, that are the intellectual capital. So evaluation of the intellectual capital, this is there. And fuzzy expert system, written, this paper is written by Muhammad Hossein, Fazal Jardani, and so on. So, and this paper was written in 2012. And it's a very the abstract in this paper. Academic copyright. This is the abstract part. This is the expert part. Just read this expert part. Abstract part. Excuse me, please. College coming. Just read this and see how this paper is designed. So these are the rules. This is the long paper. So this having the more references. References are 22. This is a good paper. So likewise this, you may write your own paper. So I think time is up now. Yes, students. Yes, please. Yes, students. I requesting you to be interactive, because you are a very senior class of MTech class, ME class. So always be communicative with the faculty, so that you can express your view and express your ideas, share your ideas with the faculty, and we can share our ideas and can guide you more closely. So basically MTech is for research. Okay, so for higher studies of some subject domain and do some research. So and ultimately your degree will be you will obtain your degree on the basis of some research or some publications. So that is very important. So explore your capability. I think it's very important. Yes, any question from your side? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much for attending this session. Thanks all.